हेलो किड्स, हाउ आर यू? गुड इवनिंग गाइस। सो टुडेज डे 5 फॉर इंड एस 103 एंड 110, बिजनेस कॉम्बिनेशन एंड कंसोलिडेशन। ओके, सो टेल मी गाइस, हाउ आर यू नाउ? Shall we start the session? Tell me, shall we start the session or not? Shall we start the session or not? Hi, Ekta Gupta. Good evening. Anirudh, Pranam. Manasi, good evening. Swati, good evening. So tell me, Damini. Damini, actually Damini Arora, she is my wife. She is now online. Okay, so shall we start? Okay, so finally we are starting the session. What is our today's topic? What is our today's topic? What will happen to other contra items like receivables and payables? I'll discuss this issue right now today. Ekta, I'll discuss this issue today. Don't worry. Or you can remind me at the end of this session. So now, our today's target is disposal of shares and chain holding. We are going to discuss these two things, disposal of shares and chain holding. Ashutosh is saying class 4 hours ka karo. Dear, it is not possible for me to extend for 4 hours. Instead, we can make multiple sessions. Okay, so our today's topics are disposal and chain holding. वैसे भी after today's session, I think whatever left will be most importantly, it is reverse acquisition and common control business combination. So if possible, I'll take the next session for 3 hours to just end up the entire things, like end up the miscellaneous things. So Ekta, one more doubt. Okay, ask me. You can ask me one more doubt. Tell. Disposal of shares and chain holding. Disposal of shares and chain holding. DDT treatment if holding company announce dividend. See, what should be the treatment of dividend distribution tax? I will discuss it separately again. Whether it is declared, the dividend is declared by holding company or by subsidiary company. Even if the dividend is declared by subsidiary company, then it is more important. So chalo, let's start. Disposal of shares. Come to this point. Let's start disposal of shares. Nupur Gupta, sir, class is available. Sir, is class 1 to 4 is available on YouTube? Yes, it is available, dear. It is available. Guys, now please concentrate. Please don't ask irrelevant points now, because I'm not going to discuss your irrelevant points for the time being. I'm starting the session disposal of shares, right? Please let me start the session with disposal of shares. See, in disposal of shares, I hope you are writing also, okay? In disposal of shares, there can be three different scenarios. Without loss of control. Now, what is this without loss of control? Without loss of control means subsidiary has 90%, holding has 90% in subsidiary, sold 20% out of above. So tell me, when holding company has 90% shares in subsidiary, 90% equity shares in subsidiary, and 20% has been sold to the market, still holding company has 70% shares. That means still holding company has control. So it is called without loss of control. We are selling the shares of subsidiary company in the market, but we don't lose the control. We actually don't lose the control. Next, disposal with loss of control. Disposal with loss of control. That means, first of all, we have more than 50% shares. We have the control over the subsidiary. But suppose we have 90% shares. Now we sold 80% shares. We lost the control. But in this situation, there can another be two subcategories. What are the subcategories? Disposal with loss of control, but got significant influence. And here, disposal with loss of control. And does not get significant influence too. Can you please explain these two things by way of example? I am waiting for your reply. Please tell me. No one has replied, or no one wants to reply. Okay, so let me explain. If you are not in a position to reply, this situation is like, okay, holding 90% share already but sold 60% share only, having 50% share. Aman Mittal, Kirandeep, suppose holding has 90% shares, sold 60% shares. Still we have 30% shares. We got significant influence. that means subsidiary converted into associate company. Subsidiary converted into associate company. Okay, and here H has 90% shares, sold 80% shares. We have 10% only. So here, no subsidiary, no associate. So these are the two things. Disposal with loss of control. There are the two things. So all in all, there are three categories. Under disposal of shares, there are three categories. And it is very simple. Disposal of shares category is very, 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 very simple. Don't worry. One important point. Disposal without loss of control. Disposal without loss of control. No need to de-recognize net assets. Only NCI will be increased. NCI will be increased. Journal entry would be, tell me what should be the journal entry. Here, what should be the journal entry? Tell me, guys. Investment to NCI, Anisha. Bank to NCI, bank account debit. Tell me, guys, we have sold the shares, so technically what entry we need to pass is bank account debit to NCI. Bank account is to be debited by sale proceeds. NCI, how much NCI will be increased? Proportion to net assets or proportion to fair value? That depends, na? NCI may be measured at proportion of net asset, or it may be measured at fair value. So NCI would be increased, and the difference to OCI, other equity. Difference to OCI, other equity. Okay, so this is the basic thing under disposal without loss of control. Under disposal without loss of control, no need to de-recognize the net assets. Net assets will be continued, and the NCI will be increased proportionately. Bank account will be debited. Whatever the difference is there, such difference will be transferred to OCI, other equity. Okay. Bank account debit, investment debit, minority interest debit, capital reserve debit, to net asset, to goodwill. Mansi, I asked journal entry for without loss of control. I think you are replying for with loss of control. I am not asking the journal entry for with loss of control. Okay. Now tell me here, what should be the journal entry? Disposal with loss of control and does not get significant influence. Tell me, what should be the journal entry? I think the journal entry which is written by Mansi is true. It is correct for this situation. What should be the journal entry? Tell me guys. what should be the journal entry? Journal entry would be bank account debit. It is sale proceeds. Now, one more important thing is derecognize net assets, NCI, goodwill / capital reserve. Recognize remaining investments. Remaining investments at fair value. That means now we are applying Ind AS 109. Now we will apply Ind AS 109. Aqib Aslam, what if we don't have fair value of net asset on the date? Beta, question will definitely give you the fair value of net asset. Definitely it will give you the fair value of net asset. Otherwise, if the question is not giving you the fair value of net asset, suppose, then at the value at which you have sold the investments, that value you can consider as the fair value, and by that fair value you can calculate the proportionate NCI. If you can remember the fair value method of NCI. So if the net asset values are not given at the date of disposal, not an issue. 99% cases, in 99% cases, institute will give you the net assets. But suppose the institute is not giving you the net asset, you can take sale proceeds as fair value base. And proportionately you can calculate NCI. Okay, Aqib, you have deleted your message, but I have replied you. Okay. Derecognize net assets, NCI, goodwill, capital reserve. In which situation? Disposal with loss of control and does not got significant influence. Recognize remaining net investments at fair value. Simply, recognize remaining investments at fair value. Guys, understood or not? Tell me guys, understood or not? And here, disposal with loss of control but got the significant influence. Here also, derecognize net assets, NCI, goodwill / capital reserve, and recognize investments in associate. Recognize investment in associates as per Ind AS 28. That is, apply equity method. Apply equity method. This is very important point. Apply equity method. This is very important point. So this is the entire summary of disposal of shares. Now let me explain again, then we will proceed with the questions, right? Under disposal of shares by holding company, there can be two main categories: disposal without loss of control, disposal with loss of control. In case of disposal without loss of control, the net assets are not to be derecognized, the goodwill are not to be derecognized, only the NCI shall be proportionately increased. Now, when I say proportionately increased, then means proportion to net assets. Understood or not? If net assets are not given, then NCI can be increased proportion to fair value. Now, how to determine the fair value? From the sale proceeds, from the sale proceeds itself. Because you have sold your investments, whatever you have got, that is the fair value of sale. So you can increase the NCI based on fair value of sale proceeds. Okay? Entry would be bank account debit to NCI. Whatever the difference will be transferred to OCI. Because it is a case of without loss of control. Understood or not? Okay. Now disposal with loss of control. Under disposal with loss of control, there can be two subcategories. When you are disposing the shares with loss of control, that means you have lost the control, but there can be a situation where you have got the significant influence. If you have got significant influence, then this is the case of conversion from subsidiary to associate. That means if your subsidiary has been converted to associate company, if your subsidiary has been converted to associate company, then also you have lost the control. That means you have to derecognize the net assets, you have to derecognize the NCI, you have to derecognize the goodwill, capital reserve, and recognize the remaining investments as per Ind AS 28. Sir, what is the name of Ind AS 28? Ind AS 28 is investment in joint venture and associate. Ind AS 28 says if you have associate company, if you have joint venture company, you have to measure the investments as per equity method under consolidated financial statements. Now you will ask that, sir, when we are disposing the shares, now onwards, why we should prepare the consolidated financial statement? I am assuming that there are more than one subsidiary companies. Suppose I have more than one subsidiary companies. Suppose I have two subsidiary companies. One is sold and the one is continued. The one which I have sold is being converted into associate company. Now I will continue to prepare the consolidated financial statement because I have another subsidiary company. So the subsidiary which has been converted into associate, for which investment shall be recognized under CFS as per equity approach, as per equity approach. But if I'm going to prepare the SFS, if I'm going to prepare the SFS, the same investments in associate company shall be measured as per Ind AS 27 cost approach or fair value approach, if you remember. So this is the summary of subsidiary to associate. So if your subsidiary is converted into associate, you have to measure the remaining investments at equity approach, equity method, under CFS only. Because under SFS, there is Ind AS 21. Under CFS, you have to apply Ind AS 28, equity approach. And the last one, if you have sold the disposed the shares of subsidiary and lost the significant influence, lost the control also, you have got nothing. Bas, only few remaining investments, less than 20%, for example. Let's say less than 20%. Then the remaining investment shall be measured at fair value, Ind AS 109. Fair value. That means, try to understand, we have so many Ind AS. We have so many Ind AS. Okay? So now, shall we proceed towards question? Tell me, guys, have you understood this point or not? Shall we proceed towards the question or not? Please send me your reply. Shall we proceed towards questions or not? Okay, shall we proceed? Fine. Okay, fine. So now you can read these things if you want. If you want, you can read these things. If some holding is disposed, control is not lost, cash account debit to NCI. Difference in amount of entry is directly transferred to another equity, other equity, that means OCI. Okay? And here, full or partial disposal, bank account debit, investment account debit, value of investments retained, if any, at fair value or equity method. इक्विटी मेथड, माइनॉरिटी इंटरेस्ट डेबिट, कैपिटल रिजर्व डेबिट टू नेट असेट्स टू गुडविल. डिफरेंस इन अबव एंट्री विल बी ट्रांसफर टू पीएनएल. ऑब्वियसली डिफरेंस इन अबव एंट्री विल बी ट्रांसफर टू पीएनएल. इफ देयर इज एनी डिफरेंस इट विल बी ट्रांसफर टू पीएनएल. सर व्हाई पीएनएल? बिकॉज वी हैव लॉस्ट द कंट्रोल. इफ यू रिमेंबर द लास्ट सेशन ऑल्सो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू, इफ यू आर नॉट लूजिंग द कंट्रोल डिफरेंस विल बी ट्रांसफर टू ओसीआई. इफ यू आर लूजिंग द कंट्रोल यू हैव टू ट्रांसफर द डिफरेंस टू पीएनएल. ओके, नाउ कम टू द क्वेश्चन. Guys, have you done this question? Question number 107. Have you done this question or not? Tell me. Have you done this question or not? Tell me. 107. Okay. Now, disposal of shares of subsidiary, question number 109. Question number 109. Question number 109. Guys, if you have any doubt in question number 107, you can ask later. You can ask later. If you have doubt in this question, you can ask later. Right now come to the question number 109 that starts from here. Entity P sells 20% interest in a wholly owned subsidiary. Do you understand what do you mean by wholly owned subsidiary? That means 100% shares. So we have 100% shares. Guys, we have 100% shares. Try to understand. We have 100% shares in the subsidiary company. That means there is a zero NCI right now. But we sold 20%. Now, when we sold 20%, the NCI will be increased by 20% proportion. To outside investors, 4 rupees 100. 100 rupees lakhs is sale proceeds. The carrying value of the subsidiary's net assets is 300 lakhs, including goodwill. Of 65, including goodwill of 65. Now see, on the date of disposal, the net asset values are given to you. 300 lakhs, including goodwill 65. So 300 into 20%, that is 60. In this case, NCI shall be increased. How much? 300 into 20%, that is 60. So entry should be bank debit 100 to NCI 60 to other equity 40 OCI. This would be the entry. NCI shall be increased. Right? NCI shall be increased. Any doubt, guys? Any doubt? Please tell me. Any doubt? Any doubt? Please tell me. Any doubt? Okay, fine. I think no one is having any doubt. Let's come to the next question. Question number 110. A parent purchased 80% interest in a subsidiary for 1,60,000. This 1,60,000 is cost of investment. On 1st April 2011, when the fair value of subsidiaries net assets are 1,75,000, goodwill 20,000 arose on consolidation under the partial goodwill method. Okay. See, first of all, they are saying 80% interest purchase at 160. So date of acquisition is 1st April 2011. On date of acquisition, your investment was 160 plus NCI was 175 का 20%, 35,000, it is 195, then net assets 175, we have got 20,000 goodwill, we have got 20,000 goodwill. Ekta Gupta, should it not be net of goodwill? No dear, it should not be net of goodwill. Net assets including goodwill we have to take. Here we have to take 300 including goodwill. Including goodwill. Here we have to take net assets including goodwill, because a goodwill you have recognized is also a part of net assets, na? Goodwill you have recognized is also a part of net asset, dear. So first of all, we got this, right? We got this on 1st April 2011. Now, an impairment of goodwill of 8,000 was charged in the consolidated financial statement to 31st March 2013. Out of this goodwill, we impaired by 8,000. Now the remaining rest, this is carrying amount of goodwill, okay. No other impairment charges have been recorded. The parent sold its investment in subsidiary on 31st March 2014 for rupees 2 lakh. Now on 31st March 14, we are selling the investments. And how much investment the parent sold its investment? I think the parent is selling its entire investment. There is no such remaining investment. Entire investments are being sold. The book value of the subsidiary's net assets in the consolidated financial statement on the date of sale was 2,25,000. Guys, this is the case of loss of control. This is the case of loss of control, and parent lost control as well as does not get any kind of significant influence. The book value of the subsidiary's net assets in the consolidated financial statement on the date of sale was 2,25,000, not including goodwill, 12,000. When the subsidiary met the criteria to be classified as held for sale under 105, no written down was required because the expected fair value less cost to sale was greater than carrying value. Theek hai. The parent carried the investment in subsidiary at cost as permitted by Ind AS 27. Okay. Now this is an important question. April 2011, investment acquired 80%. Now 31st March 2014, sold 80%, right? First of all, tell me the treatment under SFS. Under SFS, we sold the investments, bank account debit, 2 lakh rupees, to investment account, 1,60,000, to P&L, 40,000. Sir, how this entry has been passed? See, we sold the investment at 2 lakh, we purchased the investment earlier, here, at 1,60,000. So under SFS, this entry would be passed. Next, under CFS, tell me what should be the entry. I am waiting for your reply. Tell me, I am waiting for your reply. entry would be? Cash, debit to NCI, other equity. Anirudh Goyal, I am asking the entry under CFS where we have lost the control, beta. Lost the control, Anirudh. Anirudh. Bank debit, NCI debit to investment, to net asset, to goodwill. Dear, why to investment, Swati? Why we will credit the investment? In our CFS, do we have investment debited in our CFS? Swati, wrong entry. Anirudh, wrong entry. Tejasvi, bank account debit, NCI debit to goodwill. Just this? Tejasvi, only this much? See the entry. Bank account debit, rupees 2 lakh. Investment zero. Investment zero because we have sold entire investments. We have sold entire investments. Susan, investment debit 160, NCI. Susan, invest. Why you are debiting investment, guys? Have you not understood, yaar? We have sold the investments. And in our consolidated financial statement, investments are not remaining. Everyone is doing wrong entry. Cash account debit to net assets to goodwill. To goodwill. NCI. Tell me the NCI value. Tell me the net asset value. Goodwill shall be created by 12,000. Because we have only 12,000 goodwill. Earlier we recognized 20,000 goodwill. Then we impaired 8,000. Now we have only 12,000 goodwill. Now tell me the figures of NCI and figures of net assets. Figures of NCI and figures of net assets. Figures of NCI and figures of net assets. Tell me. This is the date on 31st March 2014. Here the net assets available was, I think, 2,25,000. Is it that? Yes, 2,25,000. On this date, net asset was 225. So tell me, the net asset will be created by 225. And NCI, how much? NCI will be 225 into 20%. NCI will be debited by 45,000. 20% of net assets. 20% of net assets. Investments will be created, debited at zero. Guys, have you understood this entry? NCI 225 into 20%, na? Aman Mittal, how the NCI is calculated at 33,400? Akib Aslam, NCI 35,000? How you have calculated these figures, NCI? Mansi is saying 225 into 80%. That means, Mansi, now I will increase the NCI by 80%. I am not getting anyone's point here. I'm not getting anyone's point. Nupur, wrong. Mansi, wrong. Ekta Gupta, wrong. Yes, Anirudh, there was a disturbance between in the mid of the session, but now it's okay, I think. Guys, you guys are disappointing me. You guys are really disappointing me. Tell me guys, I am waiting for your answer. ₹2 lakh plus 45,000 minus 225 minus 12,000, 8,000 will be profit to gain on sale. 8,000 consolidated profit and loss. This will be the entry. This will be the entry. Everybody is doing wrong calculation in respect of NCI. See, when you have acquired the shares on 1/4/2011, your net asset was 175. You have recognized the NCI at 35. Understood. But after 3 years, on 31st March 2004. Definitely if the value of net asset is changed, the value of NCI has also been changed. Now the carrying amount of NCI must be 45,000. Why? Proportion of net asset. So this would be the entry. This would be the entry. Aman Mittal, I am asking you once again, Aman, how you have calculated NCI at 33,400? How you have calculated NCI? At 33,400. I am explaining entry once again. See, bank account debit. Sales proceed, bank account debit, sales proceed, investment zero because we have sold all investments. Sold all investments. NCI, it should be the carrying value on 31st March 4. Right? So, on 31st March 4, our net asset was 225. That means the NCI must be 45,000, 20% of 20% of net assets. Net asset shall be derecognized because it is the carrying value on 31st March 4. Goodwill, again, carrying value. I think now entry explained. Please tell me, have you understood the entry or not? Have you understood the entry or not? Please tell me, entry has been explained. Or if you are having doubt, then please ask the doubt properly, specifically, that what actually you are facing. Okay, understood. Okay sir, Anirudh done, Swati done, Susan done, Vipu done, Anirudh done, Tejasvi done, Kirandeep done. अमन मित्तल, यू हैवेंट रिप्लाइड. मानसी, एकता गुप्ता, नुपुर, यू गाइज आर नॉट रिप्लाइंग. आई थिंक यू गाइज आर फेसिंग सम काइंड ऑफ डाउट. ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, वी हैव लॉस्ट द कंट्रोल, वी हैव टू डी रिकग्नाइज द एनसीआई, वी हैव टू डी रिकग्नाइज द नेट असेट्स, राइट? सो वी हैव लॉस्ट 80%, वी हैव सोल्ड 80% शेयर्स. नाउ नो नीड टू रिकॉर्ड द एनसीआई, नो नीड टू रिकॉर्ड द नेट असेट, जस्ट डी रिकग्नाइज ऑल ऑफ देम. प्रणाली, यस, ओके, आई एम मूविंग अहेड. This would be your homework. Aman Mittal, you haven't told me that how you have got 33,400. How you have got 33,400? I wonder actually how you have got 33,400. Please tell me. Mistakenly calculated, but how this 33,400 came, I just wanted to know. Guys, give me 2 minutes, please. Give me 2 minutes. Okay, guys, actually my pen is not working. In the meanwhile, I am asking you one another question on this, on this same question. Suppose instead of entire 80%, if we sell just 50% investment, out of 80%, we sold 50% investment and remaining 30% we retained as investment in associate. Then tell me, what should be the journal entry, at which amount the investment is to be recorded? I am just asking you one question. Instead of selling entire 80%, if I sell 50% only and rest 30% is retained, what would be the treatment? Number one, what should be the journal entry? Number two, at what amount the investments are to be recognized? Right now I am asking this question. Please solve it. Solve it, please. I am waiting for your reply. Solve it, please. Okay. My pen is working now. So, I am just giving you the example. Instead of selling 80%, we sold 50% only at 1,25,000. Subsidiary converted into associate. Tell me the answer. Now in this case, please tell me the answer. What should be your answer? Please tell me the answer. What should be your answer? Guys, are you getting my point? Please tell me. Please reply if the video is okay. Please reply if video is okay, voice is okay, please reply. Please tell me, guys. I am waiting for your reply. What should be the treatment? What should be the treatment? Okay, hint. We have to apply Ind AS 28, right? Nupur Gupta, else figure remaining same. I didn't get you, Nupur. Investments remaining shall be measured at equity approach, equity method. One more hint, if you are asking me, sir, what do you mean by equity method? What is this? Equity method means measuring investments in proportion of net assets. In proportion of net assets. Measuring investments in proportion of net assets. Measuring investments in proportion of net assets. So I have given you the hint. You can please solve the point. You can please solve the point. for just few minutes I'll not ask anything, I'll not reply anything. Bank account debit 125, NCI debit 45, investment in associate 67,500, two net assets, two gain. Dear, where is goodwill? Akib Aslam, where is goodwill? Bank debit, investment debit, NCI debit, two net asset, two goodwill, two gain. NCI, bank, two goodwill, net asset 112,500, net asset 112,500, ekta wrong. Okay, the entry would be bank account debit 1,25,000. Investment account debit 67,500, yes correct, 225 into 30%, 225 into 30%, NCI debit 45,000, two net assets 2,25,000, two goodwill 12,000, Prakash Agarwal, do concentrate on the points which we are discussing right now. Okay, I know very well what I need to upload and what I don't need to upload, so don't worry, I assure you everything will be uploaded, but please don't mess up the things. P&L 45,000, 500, 2 P&L 500, right? This would be the entry. This would be the entry. So, Sir Matthew, your entry is correct. Okay, Akib has mistakenly forget to credit 12,000 goodwill. That means your entry is also correct. This would be the entry. Understood, guys? This would be the entry. Subsidiary converted into associate. Subsidiary converted into associate. So shall we proceed further? So these are the cases where subsidiary, the investment in subsidiary company are being disposed of. So this is done. Now I am coming to the next point. Your homework. 112, your homework. Now I'm coming to the next point. Sir, why investment debited? Nupur, we sold just 50% portion. Out of 80% portion, we sold 50% portion. Rest 50% portion we are having with us. And this 30% portion is known as investment in associate. This investment in associate is to be recognized under consolidated financial statement as per equity method, beta. You are asking this silly question. Why investment is debited? Investment account is to be debited because we are having the remaining investments. Out of 80, we sold 50 only. Okay, the next is chain holding. Very important, chain holding. The next is chain holding. Next is chain holding. Guys, are you ready? Shall we proceed further? Are you ready? Shall we proceed further? Chain holding. Chain holding. Shall we start? Please tell me, are you guys ready? Shall we start? Continue. Guys, please, at least please reply that so that I shall continue, guys. Please. Okay, I got the replies now. Chain holding. Chain holding. See, chain holding is a very important concept. And what do you mean by chain holding? Under chain holding, there can be more than one subsidiary companies. There can be more than one subsidiary. Now, suppose this is the case. Holding company has two subsidiary companies, S1, S2. Here, 90% investment. Here, 80% investment. Guys, this is not chain holding. This is not chain holding. Why? Because holding company directly holds investment in both the subsidiaries. Chain holding is the case where holding company invests in one subsidiary, then the subsidiary company again invests further in another subsidiary company. That means holding company is indirectly investing through its subsidiary into the another company. That means the chain holding will be as follows. Holding company investment in subsidiary number 1, 90%, and subsidiary number 1 investments in subsidiary number 2, 80%. This is chain holding. This is chain holding. Okay, this is the case of chain holding. Even we can say case 1 and now case 2. Holding company invest 90% in S1. In S1 invest 70% in S2, and holding invest 10% in S2. These two cases comes under chain holding. These are the cases of chain holding. It can be even like this also, 40 and 50. This can be 60 and 20. Okay, understood or not? Guys, understood or not? So these two cases comes under chain holding, but this is not a question of chain holding, where holding directly holds investment in both the subsidiaries. This case is not a chain holding. This is a simple question. This is a simple business combination question, where holding company will directly consolidate S1 and directly consolidate S2. But under chain holding, there is somewhat different thing. Now, if we consider case one, guys, I am discussing first of all case one. If we consider case one, then under case one, holding in S1 is having 90%. NCI in S1 is having 10%, obviously, because holding company holds 90% investment in subsidiary 1. Understood? So this is the case. Again, holding in H in S2, although H is not directly investing in S2, but through S1 indirectly. So this is the case of indirectly. This is a case of indirectly. Since S1 holds 80% of S2 and holds 90% of S1, that means holding company holds in S2 90% of 80%. That is 72%. Therefore, NCI in S2. Therefore, NCI in S2 would be 100 minus 72. That means 28%. This is very important thing to understand. Under chain holding, you have to calculate the percentage of holding properly. You have to calculate the percent of holding properly in this way. Okay? And under case 2, holding has 90% H in S1, NCI in S1, 10%, H in S2 indirectly plus directly, see the situation. Directly we hold 10% and indirectly 90% of 70%. 90% of 70% plus 10%. So we hold 73%. And therefore NCI in S2 will be 100 minus 27%. This is the case of case 2. So like these, first of all, under chain holding, it is very important to calculate the holding percentage under chain holding. Because if your holding percentage is not correct, if it is wrong, your entire solution will become wrong. You cannot expect even a single answer, a single mark from the checker. So make sure you are calculating the correct percentage of holding and percentage of NCI. If you are having any doubt, then please you can ask. Otherwise, I am moving ahead. So these are the two cases, case 1 and case 2. Now there is one golden rule. Golden rule. Always think from parent's point of view. That means H. Always think from parent's point of view. Even H has not made any investment in S2, then only think from the point of view of H. Indirectly, it has made investment in S2 through S1. So even H has not made any kind of investment in the sub-subsidiary, that means in S2, but you have to think from the point of view of H only. That means indirectly H has made the investment in S2 through S1. So always think from the point of view of parent company or holding company. Guys, if you have done with this, not an issue. If you are having doubt, you can ask. I am moving ahead. So I discussed this first one, I discussed this second one. Guys, understood or not? I discussed this first and second situation. Now, as far as the remaining points, I am going to solve a full-fledged 16 marks question with you. And it will take actually more than half an hour. So this is going to be the very important point, chain holding. So I am going to discuss this session, discuss a particular full-fledged 16 marks examination question, so that you guys can be able to understand entirely. Okay, please reply me if you are having doubt, otherwise we are moving ahead. So the question will be, this one. Question number 113. Exam November 18, 16 marks. Prepare consolidated balance sheet of as on 31st March 18 of a group of companies comprising Usha Limited, Nisha Limited, Sandhya Limited. There are three companies, Usha, Nisha, Sandhya. The summarized balance sheet on that date are given below. The date is 31st March 18. Okay. Rupees and lakhs, equity and liabilities, Usha, Nisha, Sandhya, share capital 10 per share. Okay. Reserves, retained earnings, trade payables, bills payables, Usha and Sandhya. See, in the beginning of this session, someone has asked about, sir, please clear the concept of contra debt, debtors and creditors, common debts. So here are these. Non-current assets, tangible assets, okay, investment. Yes, this is very important point. 16 lakh shares in Nisha Limited. Guys, Usha is holding shares in Nisha. 12 lakh shares in Sandhya Limited. Guys, Nisha is holding shares in Sandhya. So it is a situation like Usha is holding shares in Nisha and Nisha is holding shares in Sandhya, and Usha becomes the parent company, Nisha becomes S1 and Sandhya becomes S2. Okay, Usha is holding 16 lakh shares in Nisha, and Nisha has total 200 divided by 10, 20 lakh shares, rupees in lakhs na. So Nisha is having 20 lakh shares, out of which 16 lakh is held by Usha. That means 80%. Now Nisha is holding 12 lakh shares in Sandhya, and Sandhya is having 160 share capital divided by 10, that means 16 lakhs. That means 16 lakhs. That means and Nisha is holding 12. So 12 divided by 16, 75%. 75%. So this is the case. This is the case. Usha is holding 80% shares of Nisha, and Nisha is holding 75% of shares of Sandhya. Okay. So it will be like, working note number 1, calculation of holding percentage. Usha in Nisha 80%, NCI in Nisha 20%. Usha in Sandhya, always think from Usha's point of view. This is a golden rule. Don't think from Nisha's point of view, even though Nisha has made directly investment in Sandhya. But think from Usha's point of view. Indirectly. So 80% of 75%. It should be 60, I think. Yes. And NCI in Sandhya. Swati. Very good. 100 minus 60. 40%. This is the calculation of holding percentage. Guys, this is the calculation of holding percentage. I hope you are not having any kind of issue in this. Right? This is the working note number 1. Now, what are the remaining points? Cash in hand, bills receivable, trade receivables, inventory. Following details are information available. Usha holds 80% in Nisha. Nisha holds 70% in Sandhya. Their holding were acquired on 30th September 2017. Guys, 30th September. The business activities of all the companies are not seasonal in nature. Therefore, it can be assumed that profits are earned evenly throughout the year. Okay. On 1st April 2017, the following balance stood in the books of Nisha and Sandhya. These are the balances on 1st April 17. So there will be a room for time adjustment. There will be a room for time adjustment. Rupees 5 lakh included in the inventory figure of Nisha is the inventory which has been purchased from Sandhya. Okay, Nisha Limited has purchased the inventory from Sandhya. What was our golden rule in case of elimination of unrealized profit? Our golden rule was, the company who earned the profit shall remove the profit. So here Sandhya has earned the profit. So the profit shall be removed from the Sandhya's profits, profit and loss. That means from the statement of changes of Sandhya. The parent company adopted policy to measure the NCI at fair value. Market price, applying Ind AS 103. Assume market price of Nisha and Sandhya are the same as respective fair face values. Time face. First of all, they are saying ki NCI is to be measured as per the fair value. Good thing. But now they are saying the market values or the fair values are same as face values. That means 10 rupees. Okay. The capital are preferably to be adjusted against cost of control. Okay. Analysis of profits and notes must be a part of your answer. Guys, here analysis of profit means a statement of changes in net assets. Okay. So just let's start preparing working note number 2. Statement of net asset changes. First of all, Nisha, date of acquisition 30th September, na? Yes, 17. Change October to March, balance sheet date March 18. Equity share capital, Nisha, 200. Then reserves and retained earnings, these are 50 and 25 on the balance sheet date, and on 1st April these are 40 and 10. So technically it is 10 and 15. Change column, right? It is 250, it is 25, it is 275. Understood, guys? Time adjustment, since there is no abnormal item, since there is no dividend, so we are making time adjustment directly. Time adjustment 12.5 262.5 12.5. One more thing, the inventory was sold by Sandhya, so it is to be eliminated from the statement of changes in net assets of Sandhya only. Okay, these are the 100% net assets on date of acquisition, and we need to bifurcate this 12.5 into Usha and NCI. Usha 80%, NCI 20%. That is 10 or 2.5. This is the statement of changes of Nisha. Again, working note number 2. Sandhya, sorry, working note number 3. Statement of changes in Sandhya, in net assets of Sandhya. Date of acquisition, change, balance sheet date, equity capital 160, reserves, retained earning 40 30 30 15 40 30 30 15. It is 10, it is 15. 160, 190, 205, 25, 230 प्लस माइनस टाइम एडजस्टमेंट सेम 12.5, इट इज 217.5, इट इज 12.5. नाउ माइनस एलिमिनेशन ऑफ अनरियलाइज्ड प्रॉफिट ऑन स्टॉक ट्रांसफर. सो 5 लाख रुपीज इंक्लूडेड इन द इन्वेंट्री फिगर ऑफ निशा. निशा हैज सम इन्वेंट्री रुपीज 5 लाख. द निशा परचेज दिस इन्वेंट्री ऑफ 5 लाख फ्रॉम संध्या. दैट मीन्स संध्या सोल्ड द इन्वेंट्री. दैट मीन्स संध्या हैज अर्न द प्रॉफिट. दैट मीन्स संध्या हैज टू रिवर्स द प्रॉफिट विच हैज बीन परचेज फ्रॉम संध्या एट कॉस्ट प्लस 25%. सो 5 लाख इंटू 25 डिवाइड बाय 125, इट इज 1 लाख. सो टेक्निकली वी एलिमिनेट 1 लाख एज रिजर्व. 1 लाख एज रिजर्व. सो 217.5 and 11.5. This is 100% net assets on date of acquisition. Bifurcate between Usha and NCI. What is Usha's share? 60% and 40%. 60, 40, 6.9, 4.6. This is statement of changes in net assets of Sandhya. Guys, three working notes have been done. Working note number 1, percentage of holding. Working note number 2 and 3, statement of changes in net assets. Now, next thing. Working note number 4. Cost of control. And working note number 5. Calculation of NCI fair value method. Cost of control, Nisha, Sandhya. Nisha and Sandhya. निशा एंड संध्या. निशा एंड संध्या एनसीआई निशा एंड संध्या एनसीआई निशा एंड संध्या First of all, tell me the amount of investments. Please 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 tell me guys, value of investments. Value of investments. I think there is a problem buffering, video is buffering. Okay, now clear. Value of investments, guys. Aman Mittal is saying 170 and 112. See, first of all, 170 is to be taken investment value. Here, see, Usha has direct investment in Nisha, but indirect investment in Sandhya. Actually, Nisha has invested 140 in Sandhya. See, I am telling you one thing. Who is the ultimate parent company? Usha is the ultimate parent company. Okay. Now, Usha has control over the assets of Nisha. That means Usha has control over the investment of over this investment also. Usha has control over this investment also. Likewise, if Usha is the ultimate parent company and Usha holds 80% of Nisha, that means Usha is having sharing of 80% in Nisha. That means in this investment, that is the asset of Nisha, Usha has 80% investment, 80% share. So, investments, here we will write 140 into 80%, that is 112. Why? 140 into 80% only. Because rest is for NCI of Nisha. NCI means other shareholders of Nisha. Guys, Nisha's net assets includes 140 investments. So in the Nisha's net assets, Usha has 80% sharing. So in the Nisha's 140 investment, Usha has 80% investment, because we have calculated the percentage like this. So if there is 140 asset, out of which 20% belongs to the other shareholders of Nisha, and that is the reason we write only 112 here. Anirudh Goyal, this is not 170 and 84, it should be 170 and 112. Have you understood this point? If you have doubt, then you can ask. Then plus NCI on date of acquisition. Now, if we calculate NCI on date of acquisition, that means you have to calculate the number of or percentage of holding. Here 20%, here 40%. Number of shares based on above percentage. Based on above percentage. actually there is a network issue in this session, and this is the reason why I prefer to take my classes in the morning only. So NCI, number of shares. Twenty means 20% 4 lakhs. Here 4 lakhs. Fair value or face value, these are same. That means 10 and 10. So it should be 40 and 64. This is NCI on date of acquisition. NCI on date of acquisition 40 and 64. Understood? So 40 and 64. Wait a minute, I have to check what is the problem. Actually, everyone is saying there is a problem in buffering. Please tell me, can you hear me, guys? Now can you hear me? Please tell me. Don't worry, guys. I'll explain it again. First of all, I am explaining why I took 112 investment. See, the original investment of Sandhya. Original investment of Sandhya is 140. But the investment in Sandhya 140 made by Nisha. and that means the 140 is the investment, is the asset of Nisha, and in the asset of Nisha, Usha has 80% share. So we took 80% of this asset because remaining 20% belongs to the other shareholders of Nisha, right? As far as NCI is concerned, how we calculated NCI? NCI holding percentage holding is 20 and 40 based on the working note number 1. Based on working note number 1, the percentage of holding was 20% and 40%. Number of share based on above percentage 4 lakh and 6.4 lakh. Fair value or face values are same. It is given in the question. Given 10 rupees, 10 rupees. So NCI we got 40 and 64. So 170 plus 40, 210. 112 plus 64, 176 minus 100% net assets. 100% net assets. 100% net assets. 100% net assets on date of acquisition. So 100% net assets are 262 and 217, 262, 217, 100% net assets, 210 minus 262.5, it should be 52.5 capital reserve, 176 minus 217.5. It should be 41.5 capital reserve. Capital reserve. Working of NCI. See this working of NCI. I think there is not a network issue now, guys. I think now it's correct. Okay. And this is cost of control, 52.5 41.5. this is cost of control, this is cost of control, 52.5 41.5. Okay, one thing, I'll just upload this session on YouTube, okay, because everyone is saying there is a network problem. So I'm just ending this live session stream because now maximum part we have done. So now the for the remaining part, I'm just recording the session on offline mode and will upload the entire session, right? Wait a minute, we'll upload the entire session. Okay, so now the rest of the session I am recording it on offline mode. Okay, so now this was the working of cost of control, capital reserve 52.5, 41.5. And this is the working of NCI. Now in this working of NCI, we have to add the post acquisition shares, post acquisition share, that means this is 2.5 and this is 4.6, right? 2.5, 4.6, add these things, 42.5 and 68.6 minus remaining investment of Nisha in Sandhya, which is held by other shareholders of Nisha. See, under cost of control working, how much investment we took? We took 112 out of 140. So 140 minus 112, the remaining is 28. It belongs to the other shareholders of Nisha. So technically, if it belongs to the other shareholders of Nisha, so under Nisha's NCI, I am deducting from here 28. Sir, why you are deducting? We need to increase it, na? No, we have to deduct because NCI is having credit balance always. And these 28 investments are debit balance always. So when we are saying that these 28 belongs to the other shareholders of Nisha, so it should be set off with the NCIs of Nisha. Okay, so 42.5 minus 28, it is 14.5 and it is 68.6. So it is totally 83.1 NCI. See the answer. See the answer. 83.1 NCI. And here it is. Capital reserve 52.5, 41.5. Guys, understood or not? So the under chain holding, these are the two important workings. These are the two very important workings. First is cost of control and next is NCI. I am explaining you once again. Here we took investment 170 as it is because it is our direct investment. But here we took 112 because it is our indirect investment. Because it is our indirect investment, we took 112 only. Understood or not? And the rest 28 belongs to the other shareholders of Nisha. So the other shareholders of Nisha will have 28 investment share. In the same way, when we calculate the NCI of Nisha and Sandhya, the percentage are 20 and 40. How 20 and 40? See this. This is 20 and this is 40. So based on 20 and 40, fair values are 10. Obviously, number of shares based on 20 and 40, 4 lakhs and 6.4 lakhs. These are the NCI. These are the NCI. Guys, understood or not? Okay. Post acquisition share. Okay. Now, why we have deducted this 28? Because this 28 was the share of investment in Nisha, investment by Nisha in Sandhya, and it belongs to the other shareholders of Nisha. So this is why we have deducted. Why we have deducted? Because the investment are having debit balance and the NCI are having credit balance. So definitely we have to net it off. So technically it becomes 83.1. So now the remaining entire question will be simple. We can prepare another working, like working note number 6, consolidated other equity or SOKI. Consolidated other equity or SOKI, where reserves plus retained earning, there will be one capital reserve, another, and NCI, right? Balance with Usha. Usha has balance of 90 and 80, that means 170 plus post acquisition share Nisha and Sandhya. So Nisha and Sandhya post acquisition share we got 10 and 6.9. 10 and 6.9. Then NCI working note number 5. NCI working note number 5, 83.1. And NCI and capital reserve working note number 4, 94. So all in all it is 170 plus 10 plus 6.9, it is 186.9, 94, 83.1, total 364 consolidated SOCI. Okay, now what is to be done? Simply, when you will prepare the balance sheet, the inventory figure, where is the inventory figure? The inventory figure to be written like this: 110 Usha, Nisha 35, Sandhya 25 minus 1 stock reserve, elimination of 1. Okay, so the net inventory would be 110 35 25 minus 1, the net inventory would be 69, consolidated inventory figure. Another one thing more, here we are showing bills payable to Usha 35 and here bills receivable from Nisha 36. So 36 35 only one will be shown, only one will be shown. Sandhya 15 and 15, it is to be cut it off. So 15 15 bills receivable, bills payable cut off, and bills receivable set 36 and 35 cut off, only one rupee shall be shown as net bills receivable or check in hand or cash in or checks in hand or cash in transit. Maybe why Nisha is disclosing 35 bills payable? Maybe 1 lakh has been paid by Nisha to Usha, but Usha haven't received yet. So 1 rupee shall be treated as cash in transit or check in transit or net bills receivable. Like, understood? The rest question will be like, only we have to prepare the consolidated balance sheet. You have to prepare the consolidated balance sheet. I think we have done this question of chain holding. So what is the idea under chain holding? First of all, calculate the percentage of holding properly. Then after calculating percent of holding, under the working of cost of control and NCI, make sure that under the working of cost of control, when you are taking indirect investments, then only the proportionate investment will be taken and the rest will be deducted from the NCI. Okay, so this is the point, and the same is written on the notes. I'll show you. See, this is the point. Prepare a statement of changes in net assets of both the subsidiaries and bifurcate the post acquisition column into two parts, parent share, NCI share. Okay, while calculating goodwill, gain from bargain purchase and cost of control working, the value of investment shall be taken as under full value of investment made by parent in direct invest subsidiary, investment made by S in SS into parent share. That means in case of indirect subsidiary, you have to take proportionate investment only. Therefore, take proportionate investment only in case of indirect subsidiary. Right? The last point, the portion of investment belongs to NCI because you have taken proportion. So the remaining one, that is 28 lakh, the portion of investment belongs to NCI, that is investment made by S in double S into NCI share, that is 28, shall be deducted from the final working of NCI. Since NCI is having credit balance and investment is having debit balance, therefore it is deducted. So this is the case of chain holding. Guys, yes, I know, because of network connectivity, you could not ask your questions on live session, so that is the reason I ended the live session, and I decided to record the remaining session, because I cannot end this session in between, in the mid of this. So I just recorded this session. If you have any kind of doubt, you can ask me in the on the WhatsApp, right? So we have done with chain holding, we have done with disposal. Now in the next class, that means the last class, day 6 class, I will take day 6 class of live lecture. I will inform you one day before, and that live lecture will be taken in the morning only, so that generally I will take it in the next day only. Okay, so thank you guys, thank you so much, bye bye, Jai Mata Di, Allah Hafiz.